On these next two videos, we're going to go through the facial bones of the skull. There's 14 of them. They're listed here. You can see many of them are paired. Only two of them are single, like the mandible, your lower jaw, and vomer, which we saw in the last video, which is the inferior portion of the nasal septum. But we're going to go through each of these facial bones individually on the next two videos and pay attention to these bones and know that they're facial bones and be able to distinguish the 14 facial bones from the 8 cranial bones. We're going to start with the mandible, which is the lower jaw. Let's read through the important points of the mandible, and then we'll look at an image. Mandible is the only movable bone in the entire skull. So we're talking about the 14 facial bones and the 8 cranial bones. Out of all of those bones, there's only one bone that actually moves, and that is a mandible, as a result of the TMJ joint with the temporal bone. It houses some foramina, which is plural for foramen, which are holes, in the chin region, which is the mental region. And its condylar process articulates with the mandibular fossa of the temporal bone, which we saw in one of the first two videos on the cranial bone. So let's see what all this means on the next slide, which has the images. Here they are. So this condylar process, sometimes called a condyle or a condyle of the mandible, see another one here, is what articulates with that mandibular fossa, which we saw in the temporal bone, and that's your TMJ joint. Some other good landmarks for lab. Here's the coronoid process, which is an attachment point for tendons, which will pull up on the mandible so you can open and close it. We have mental foramen on both sides. You can't see the left side. Passageway for nerves and blood vessels. We see a mandibular foramen. There's one on each side, which is an opening for nerves. This is the body of the mandible. This is the ramus of the mandible. And this angle is where the body meets the ramus. Next facial bone is the maxilla. There's two of them. We can call them maxillary bones. First important point is the keystone bone of the facial bones. Recall that the sphenoid bone is the keystone bone of the cranial bones. However, the maxilla, or maxillae plural, are the keystone bones of the facial bones. That means that all other facial bones articulate with the maxilla except the mandible, right? So there's an exception for this keystone bone. The maxillary bones contain a sinus. It's the largest of your sinuses, and it makes up most, it says, two-thirds of the hard palate. The other one-third is not part of the maxilla bone. It is the palatine bone, which is further down on this list of cranial bones. So let's look at these underlying points on an image. So here's an inferior view of the skull with the mandible removed. And we see your hard palate, the roof of your mouth. We can see the majority of the hard palate, two-thirds of it, is part of the maxilla, which we call this portion of the maxilla the palatine process. The remainder of the hard palate, the posterior one-third of the hard palate, is not part of the maxilla. It's its own bone, which we call the palatine bone. So the maxilla consists of the upper jaw, which is the region above your upper teeth. It kind of goes around the nasal cavity as well. This is all maxilla bone. And then it also includes the roof of your mouth, which we can see here, which we call the palatine process, not the palatine bone, which is a separate bone. Here's a better view of the maxilla, which is the upper jaw. Of course, it includes the hard palate as well in the interior. But this slide is for the zygomatic bones, which are the cheekbones. We see it in a kind of a light bluish green gray here. We see it on this side as well. Remember, the zygomatic process is on the temporal bone, which reaches toward the zygomatic bone. two other facial bones here. The nasal bones, which are a pair of bones that articulate with each other, which form the bridge of the nose, are two more facial bones. And then we have two lacrimal bones. Lacrimal means pertaining to tears. So your lacrimal bones are near your tear duct, which you can see very subtly right here on the medial aspect of the orbit. There's one on this side as well. There'll be a little fossa there with a duct that leads to the nasal cavity for tear drainage. So there are your two small little lacrimal bones, which exist bilaterally in the medial aspects of the orbits.